number three for
the 33rd Victorian State Archery Championships. We've had fantastic weather this weekend, better than we ever expected, and we hope for some really good scores at the end of the championships today.
We can see here just how technical and modern archery has become. Under the international rules of FITA, we are allowed to use stabilisers to help us control the bow. Lance Geimer is seen there with a very fast reaction and follow through. And I think we'll see a good score from that arrow. Here we are with Lance Geimer with a white nose, and also the number three medalist, bronze medalist in Brisbane, Mike Cohen. Everybody's here scoring their arrows after the six arrows shot. Here we have Marilyn Rumley, number three in the world in the 1981 World Championships. Just coming back from a little letdown of form, but she's really trying hard to catch that number one position. Here we see Christine McMullen pulling the last arrow, who is actually leading the tournament in the ladies at the moment. A new face to the tournament line. Penny Rowe on the compound section is now using a compound bow, a bow with mechanical advantage to get the arrow to move quicker.
Here we have a bow called a compound bow. This has been seen on the tournament lines over the last few years and is a departure from the standard bow. It has a mechanical advantage in that it has eccentric wheels at the top and bottom limb and a cable that runs between the two eccentric wheels with a string in the centre. When we pull this bow back, it doesn't increase in strength. We get to a certain point and the weight drops off. We can now hold this and sight through a peephole down through a telescope sight, which makes the bow much more accurate. And we also have a spirit level to give us a level like this so that we know when we're perfectly stable. We see there that the cable in fact accelerates as it goes forward, unlike a standard bow where the string actually tends to slow down towards the end of its travel. Therefore, we have, when the arrow leaves the bow, an arrow travelling much faster and much flatter in trajectory.
At the present time, there are no international regulations covering the compound shooting line. Unfortunately, we have very few shooters here on the line today, and because of it, we're not going to see a great competition. However, that doesn't mean that big scores are not shot. Here we see Bill Williams, the eventual winner of this competition, about to shoot, and he is amongst the top two in Australia today. We're now back on the ladies' line, and we see Dawn Nelson here just bending over, making an adjustment to her sight. She is the under-18 champion of Australia, winning three gold medals in Perth in the Junior Nationals this year. I think Dawn is a great archer, and she certainly deserves to get that number three position in this championship. A good arrow there, right in the 10. Marilyn once again, nice concentration, quite quickly shooting that arrow, but obviously with a good release there, she should get a good score. And Marilyn finishes the competition in second place. Christine McMullen leading the tournament at the moment, just making a little adjustment to her sight for the crossed wind, knocks the arrow, little pause for concentration, draws the bow, anchors nice and tightly into the chin, and aims and waits for that brain to organise itself and the bow and release the trigger straight into a 9. Shooting over the distances of 70, 60 and 50 and 30 metres, Christine McMullen has shown good form and positive concentration to win this tournament here today. Alan Lazarus, Chief Administrator of the Archery Society of Victoria, is one of the top competitors here today and is consistent in his shooting form. As the president of the Archery Society of Victoria, perhaps you'd just like to tell me how you managed to be up amongst the top three shooters today. Does your job not entail you having long hours of paperwork, or can you get some shooting in?
It's pretty well like any other administrative job, Wesley. the paperwork does get fairly involved. The time that you have to spend actually on administrative duties does mount up quite a bit. But I believe that if I want to function correctly as a president for the society, we've got 800 members, remember, I must know what each and every member is thinking at any particular time. I've got to know how they feel. The only way I can do that is to be a competitive shooter.
The under 18 champion, Russell Holst, has worked his way through the field today. He's got on top of Alan Lazarus and he's taking the third position in this tournament. A very good effort by a young man. Another young man here, Lance Geimer. He has taken out the second place in the state championships today and certainly slow to start, but arrow after arrow has crept up to really secure that second place. The men shoot over a distance of first 90 metres, then 70, 50 and 30. 36 arrows are shot at each distance. Handing out the arrows is the tournament leader and Australia's top archer, Mike Cohen.
Well, I'm only beginning my build-up for the Nationals at the moment, so my shooting is down a little bit. I'm very hopeful that over the next month or so that it will get up to the scores I expect. Even though I'm not shooting the best at the moment, I haven't got anybody really pushing me, which is a pity. It's good to have someone push you to bring out the best. Yeah.
The men are on the line for the last few arrows of the day. We certainly know who the winner is going to be, and we know the reason why. Mike Cohen, positive, sure, perfect with every shot, is now the 1983 Victorian champion.